I studied guitar and composition, working with movies and organizing festivals, cinema, and
just project
to provide music. Show you some of the stuff that is made till now. It's all quite raw and not finished. It's not mixed, and we have found some ways how to work with it.
And there are still 5 days left to work on the pieces. We have to leave next Monday, and I think these are a few words of Louis Marion Börle, it's a German name, called also known.
Okay, so
together we are the two Philips. Yeah. He didn't want to pronounce his name.
Well, so this project was founded like 2004, and we were interested in we became interested in live sampling, and we started to work. I was playing jazz guitar. Time that I don't do anymore so much, and Martin was sampling the material I was playing, and we were trying to make some music with it, but we never got really happy with it. So somehow we didn't felt so right with the setup, and so we started improvising, just like Martin improvising with different kind of software, and I was improvising, starting to use more electronic sounding sounds on the instrument, and not so much the jazz idiom that I was playing before. And so this was our first attempt to do and play some local gigs and stuff. And in 2006, Marion found Lisa, the program was developed here, and started working with this. And this was our second attempt to start to do something with live sampling, and again we were not very confident.
Now I start to talk at the same time a little bit about the process we made the last week. So I think I will start to present one of the tracks, and it's based on a system we discovered in this room next to this wall. And it's everything about feedbacks. So Matsch is playing with the guitar feedbacks, and I record with Lisa feedbacks and play them again, and I pick up the feedbacks running through processes during the guitar amp and so on. It's all about circles and feedbacks, and this is what we made out of it today.
Because it's basically not finished. And when we came here, we were planning like, okay, we want to do this, we want to have material, we want to have a CD. So we were like, sure, okay, we need to have everything fixed. We need like 5 pieces. It's gonna be 40 minutes, and it's gonna be like blah blah blah. And so we need really good preparation. But in the end, it came out that just before we came here, we had to work on a radio play that was making the music for. So there was obviously no time for real preparation for the CDs or 2 weeks. It's really not so much time. So we decided to find some titles that would make us think about like in which direction can we go, because we have tons of material that we recorded from improvisations, but how to focus it on a CD. So this was something that was for us clear, that if you listen to something on a CD, it's something that is completely different when you listen to it on a live concert. So it's not like improvised music on CD is sometimes, for me at least, really boring while it's during the performance, because the performance is becoming an integral part of the music. So if you don't have this on the CD, something's missing for me often. So we thought like we have to find a mixture between these things. And one thing we did is we found in the newspaper a title. It was in the earlier times, we have heard that the English newspapers, when there was fog on the channel, they would write "continent isolated," right? So this kind of mixing of perspectives we wanted to have in another piece.
Today, and I think at the moment we still don't know what we are doing with these pieces during the next 5 days, because we are kind of in the middle of the time we can spend. Oh, not exactly in the middle, but we have 5 days left to work on all the material. And one piece more, it's called Once Upon a Time at the moment. And yes, I think we should listen.
The other two. Thank you. Are you aware of other existing, I mean, you're using Max MSP Chitta, right, which has a long tradition of making motion capture systems. Are you aware of what's happened in the whole scene in the last 10, 15 years? Have you looked at different examples, or what's your reference? Maybe?
Well, I have looked at some examples, and I've seen amazing stuff, and I'm just starting to use this program, so I'm like, in the very first steps of like, building up. That's from the video side, if you have, or is
just... Well, I think it's a question to both of you, I think,
yeah,
in a way.
You have, okay. Oh, okay. So let's see, we have so I have to read the colors, okay. Yeah. Okay. Red is not here. No, we are having a problem with the battery for the transmitter that is sending strange data now.
Thank you. Gestures and see what kind of sound reactions you get from the system. But does it ever come to a point where you start thinking about the sounds only and then the gestures just follow?
Yeah, that's a good point. This actually this researching period for us also it took quite a lot of time to figure it all out, how technically it works. So I would like to continue this researching part. So this is really something that was not so long explored actually, how can I move, because now it's everything is kind of new and it's okay, it goes longer and I know the basic principles, but of course there is a long way where you can really go with this, and if you are just going for the sound, not thinking about the image, anything, it's just a very different approach. So now I didn't do it. But
do you think the sound is expressive enough so that you will really want to explore that space, or is it, you know, just because the gesture space is really complex and you have lots of expressive power there, but maybe the sound space that corresponds to it is not expressive enough because it's a mapping, it's like a downsampled, squashed mapping.
But I think there is it's just a matter of perspective, maybe. And if I would just concentrate on sound, so the visual of the image would be anyway there. It's just, if I understand the question right, then it's just like a way of approaching all this technology now. If I should, go for listening, what is changing, and these minimal things, which are not maybe expressive enough, but are very expressive, but they might be expressive enough to make it happen. So it would be more fragile or delicate, maybe. But if this was the question.
I'm trying to understand what part of this experience is more rewarding to you, or, you know, is it the surprise factor that really, you know?
Actually, I would like to go deep.
Okay.
So, yeah, I would really like to have this time to think, but let things happen and really. Yeah, maybe only play with sounds, or because your visual thing is quite flat. Like if I'm all the time concerning also that I know these things that now I was also I knew that this is the volume and this is the pitch. Like I had them in mind, but if I would just completely let them go and go for the intuition inside, it would be. I think the trip would be deeper for me at least, maybe also for audience. But this is the period of researching, so.
I have a question also, it's really interesting, but what comes to my mind, beyond the improvisation research, the improvisation period in which you are, put together different media and generate this specific atmosphere under improvisation, have you foreseen the possibility to put as an assemblage, really, your performance, the video and the music to really construct something specific, let's say like put it together. It would be subject for representation. I'm thinking, for instance, like in an orchestra, you put together the instruments, and you have a song or a harmony or so, it can be represented every time. Because in dance, of course, you have choreography and direction. In music, you have specific notation. And for instance, in video art, how would be the notation for to really be able to repeat, not only to improvise mix out or so, which is interesting anyway, but to really concrete some assemblage with different media and be able to repeat it, but with an artistic interpretation every time.
Yeah.
I don't know if you are thinking of
it. I think it wouldn't be then exactly the same, but there are some things which are working, maybe some hiding and then taking it out. This can be remembered and this can be noted and this can be represented.
Because what Eric was thinking is not so much into the dance part or the music part, but in when you're moving the camera.
Yeah.
If it can be really made a whole movie, the choreography, but the assemblage of the different media have the notations and be able to repeat it but with a spontaneous interpretation, I don't know if you...
Yeah, we think it's possible to do it. It's possible to have all this fixed kind of process or points where you go and you do things, and in the meanwhile you have a little bit of space of mistake or improvisation, or go to certain points where everything matches, or even be so precise that the frame or the, let's say, the camera is very much about the frame so far in this process. So yeah, to be precise about what is falling in the camera, and I think it's possible to find a annotation. I mean, if it's possible to find annotation for movement in dance, I think for this it could be even more simple. I mean, that's what I foresee now. And it can be linked to the dance and the sound, of course. So I think it's possible, and we are also seeing that we also would like to make pieces like that. We made actually already one piece which was sort of like that. We had some like specific things that we had to do, and we rehearsed it, we practiced, and then within that we had some free moments where we could play with some elements on stage.
Yeah, I also think that maybe if that's a part of the movement part is going to fix, then he can also remember where to take.
Yeah.
In that sense, it's just.
And if that has been done, because you mentioned that it's great, yeah, I assume that this kind of experiments with media and dance and music has been taking place a long time ago, but I wonder if there has been actually, let's say, like a composer make a piece, there has been someone already put together this assemblage of media and art, put it together in a, put it a name or something, or not yet. I ask because I have an idea.
Yeah, I actually don't know if that exists like that. If anybody knows, please.
Well, there's a very strong tradition of making more choreographed, composed pieces. If you look at some of the big dance companies, from Christine de Chatel, NDT to Foresight, to all the students, most of the students these days at the theatre school, they do develop pieces which use media in a more linear way, right?
Yeah.
So that is actually a way, and by definition you will have to make choices. So a system like this would have to be presetable. You have to be able to change from one to the next. You have to deal with time in a different way. So, whereas I think what they're trying to here is to develop a system where they can play. So it's not necessarily, it's more a dynamic system. So that one of them influences the reaction of the other one. So I think, and it's a question of game, right? Game as a play thing. So I think somewhere along the lines, if you talk about a feedback system, it's a three-point feedback system, I think, which is not there, but they're exploring that. So that each one's action changes the action of the other one, which has a reaction. So it's a dynamic system which you cannot predict, but you can repeat. Mm-hmm. And that, by definition, is a contradiction in terms to a linear system of most pieces that are put in front of an audience that go there the next night and want to see more or less the same thing again. So, and there's a tradition of both things. By definition, the sort of more interactive is used for the terminology, but it's the wrong way, it's the wrong terminology. That is seen as more experimental.
Yeah,
but there's a strong tradition, certainly in the Netherlands, in that.
There is a feeling to take on the idea of dynamic, which I think you suggested that this was your point of departure, this playfulness between the three elements. There is a feeling, I might be mistaken, that it's a movement that is defining everything. Mm-hmm. And that maybe if we could feel that the music and the imagery
provide or even interfere with her movement. I mean, for now, as an audience now today, yeah. I feel that it's a movement that is defining, and that the music produced and the sound are to a lesser degree of interest because they are not imposing their own sort of thing on
The camera closed. Weren't you? I mean, you were walking around with the camera, and you were, you know, really going in. You were really taking over at times, or not? With the, you know, like the wow, you know, was,
yeah.
Or not? I mean, in a way, you're interacting.
Yeah.
So,
yeah,
then you took control. I thought at times.
In that part, let's say that's the control I can take. So I can choose.
And that's interesting. I think when there's two, you know.
I agree with you. We have very good parameters still to handle. And right now the way we have structured them, I think it's strong enough to then from there start to build up more things and more things. So yeah, I agree.
More playful, like to confuse almost.
Yeah,
and I felt also the same thing that I was really active all the time, like I did, but I didn't have a space to react, or I didn't. Yeah, maybe what you said about the sounds, it could be something that I'm actually starting to listen to the sounds, even if I'm producing them, they become my my initiation or something. So I would start to play and listen.
Michelle, I have a question for you. So you're working with tools that are actually computational, for instance, tracking. You know, you need to have some ideas of what the computational part can do for you. And I remember the disappointment with the facial expression system in the interface. So how do you select the tools? How do you really interact with computer scientists or developers of image processing algorithms? How do you know what technology can give you and what it cannot give you?
How can I know?
Are there platforms, resources?
You are focusing on this software in this period, CGMax and SPG Theory. So it's mainly about this software at the moment.
So that's the boundaries of the toolbox.
Yes, for this example, yes.
You don't write the software yourself?
My software?
Yeah, yeah, that's another tool of your.
You can, but even then, there are limits to what the current state of the art can give you, for instance. You know. We can track faces, but if it's dark, we cannot.
You can use it from it.
Okay.
Well, okay, thank you very much for this presentation.